This is Nothing Phone 1, the most hyped and talked phone in the last year. And this is Nothing Phone 2. It is not just an upgrade to a Nothing Phone 1, but it's not a hardware major update, but there are a lot of software upgrades. When you hold Nothing Phone 2, the first thing you will notice is that it has got thin metal bezels than comparing to Nothing Phone 1, and which will make you feel that you are holding a small phone, not a bigger phone. Nothing Phone 2 is 6.7 inches, which is just 0.15 inch bigger than its predecessor Nothing Phone 1, and it weighs 201.2 grams, which is just 7.7 grams more than Nothing Phone 1. And Nothing Phone 2 comes with the same 120 hertz as it was in Nothing Phone 1, but this time it is LTPO OLED display. With this LTPO, it can go up to as low as 1 hertz refresh rate. Rather than from 60 to 120 hertz, it saves a lot of battery. And there is a jump in battery capacity from 4500 Nothing Phone 1 to 4700 mAh battery in Nothing Phone 2 with a support of 45 watt charge as compared to Nothing Phone 1, which is about 33 watt. And it also supports 15 watt wireless charge and 5 watt reverse charge, and which is exactly the same as Nothing Phone 1. And in Nothing Phone 2, there is a big jump in the processor from Snapdragon 778 Plus in Nothing Phone 1 to Snapdragon 8 Gen Plus 1 in Nothing Phone 2, which is good for battery management, gaming. There is a good heat management in this Snapdragon 8 Gen 1, and also there is a huge improvement in the processing of the photos. And Nothing Phone 2, the front camera comes with a 32 megapixel, which is two times the predecessor Nothing Phone 1. Portrait shots are very nice. The video quality is way superior than Nothing Phone 1. This is how it looks and how it is visible, and the sound. You can check the quality when I am walking and recording with the front camera with 1080 with 60 FPS. Rear camera is still the 50 megapixel camera as in Nothing Phone 1, but there is a huge difference in photo processing algorithms behind the scenes, which will give you spectacular and very huge difference in between Nothing Phone 1 photos and Nothing Phone 2. And these are some of the pictures taken from Nothing Phone 2. Night mode, peak bright sunlight, and in still Nothing Phone 2, you don't have an extra option to select a night mode, and night mode is automatically comes as it is in Nothing Phone 1. But accessing camera settings in Nothing Phone 2 is a little bit different from Nothing Phone 1. While the camera is on, you need to drag it like this to access camera settings. This is a problem too. Let's say you clicked on it to make it a focus and it stays. Now, if I want to access camera settings, I can't. To access, I have to go back and come again to access settings. By this act, I lost my focus settings. Nothing Phone 1, I can do focus adjustments, and I can click this arrow on top and change from 12 megapixel to 50 megapixel. Nothing I am losing, and it's pretty quick. This is how it looks and how the sound quality is when I'm recording with the back camera with 4K video 60 fps. And also Nothing Phone 2 comes with 1600 nits under HDR peak brightness, which will help you to use your phone in bright day sunlight no problem. But here in India this is a rainy season, and Nothing Phone 2 is IP54, but this is just one rate higher than Nothing Phone 1. And also Nothing is very design conscious and brand conscious like other Samsung and iPhones. If you could see this timer, which looks exactly like this pin ejector tool. And also you can customize this always on display. If you have Nothing ES stick is connected, then it can directly show you the left earbud percentage, battery percentage, and right earbud battery percentage, and the case battery percentage. And Nothing did it again. They have introduced a lot of cool stuff again in Nothing Phone 2, just like Nothing Phone 1 was introduced with the glyph interface, which was having 5 LED slots in Nothing Phone 1. And there is one functionality which was attached to that glyph interface is the battery indicator. Like that, in Nothing Phone 2 also there are 11 different LED slots, let's say glyph LED slots, which are which can be assigned to different functionality, not just a battery indicator. Let's suppose when we increase and decrease the volume, and you can see the glyph lights range is increasing and decreasing. Similarly, you can assign a particular apps to essential notification, which will light up and keep on displaying until you see the notification. But here I found something different. When the glyph light is on, when I get a notification, the moment I open the phone lock, it disappears. Though I haven't seen the notification, I haven't opened the notification yet, but the glyph light is already off. And another cool stuff is the glyph timer is a new addition to this. You can literally see the glyph light change the bar once you set the timer and keep the phone flip sliding down. As it gets, the timer is completing, the glyph light bar is also getting reduced. Also there is a glyph torch in Nothing Phone 2, which was not in Nothing Phone 1. Normally if you click once, you get to see the normal torch, and if you long press the torch, you will get this glyph torch. And also this particular LED slot is currently assigned to only to two apps, that is Zomato and Uber, to show how far they are to the destination to reach. And I believe Nothing will definitely extend these functionalities to other apps too. But the whole internet is divided into two parts with regard to this glyph lighting and all. One say this is just a gimmick and Nothing is value adding to this phone. And one part of the group says that it has got a lot of reducing distractions so that you don't need to see always the screen. But still you get the notification which are required to be attended. And also to reduce this distraction, Nothing has also got a new set of icon packs, that is Nothing icon pack, which is completely into black and white, except some of the apps still can't be updated. They are still with their brand colors. Many times you wanted to click something due to the distraction of the colorful icons. You might have opened some other apps such as Instagram or YouTube, and you continue to use them indefinitely. Also on the home screen, you can customize these icons. You can create a group of related apps like this, and you can access these big icons in the group directly. And if you click this small icon grid, which will give you access to other in that group. Also, there are plenty of other options to customize, like grid 1, circle, cover, to which you can assign particular emoji if you don't want to show anything upfront. Also, you can minimize and maximize the icon as per your choice. And another big update is create our own glyph ringtones. Use Glyph Composer app. And I have tried many times and I have been addicted to this composing. This works pretty well and I have tried Happy Birthday. Which is pretty amazing and it's really, really fun. And apart from this, there are a lot of widgets you can access from here. There is a Nothing widgets, which was earlier called Nothing Launcher. And this weather app was included in the Nothing Launcher in Nothing Phone 1. But this has got a separate dedicated widgets. Weather is separated from Nothing widgets. Apart from these major changes, but still there are a lot of small things has been changed in Nothing Phone 2. For example, this video recording light, which was a circle in Nothing Phone 1, but now it is a small horizontal line blinking. And these black bezels around the screen is less as compared to Nothing Phone 1. And the camera is now centered as compared to the Nothing Phone 1, which was the left corner. And these volume rockers are a bit low, which give a good access to volume control with one hand. When it comes to price, Nothing Phone 1 was introduced less than 30,000 and Nothing Phone 2 was introduced around 45,000 rupees, the starting range. There is a huge jump in Nothing Phone price strategy. That is because if you could see, there is no major hardware updates, but you would feel that there are many software upgrades. Like rear camera is still the 50 megapixel camera, but there is a huge difference in Nothing Phone 1's photos and Nothing Phone 2. And they have introduced new glyph lights, glyph composer, glyph timers, new widgets, and new customized icons, and glyph tools, many software side. So if you feel that there is nothing hardware upgrade, but I would recommend you to look at the software's smoothness and refresh rates. And now they have moved to LTPO OLED, which is a very good battery saver. This scenario you will get to see in other flagship phones like Samsung S21 Ultra, OnePlus 9 Pro, which is a flagship features that you are getting in Nothing Phone 2. And I feel price jump is recommended, and at the same time they can't change the hardware very drastically, otherwise they will lose their identity. That's all in this video, guys, and I tried to put all my two to three weeks of heavy usage. I put all the things in front of you, and if you have any different thoughts, maybe a heating issue, the camera problems, the refresh issues, because all devices can't be the same. I am still observing, is there any dusting problem, but still right now there is no dusting problem, which is a huge problem with my Nothing Phone 1, though I got it repaired twice. I didn't see those things in Nothing Phone 2. If you feel something is different, please let me know in the comments. That will helpful for me and other users also. And thanks for watching, and please like, share and subscribe. Catch you in the next video.